Welcome back to DePauw Sports fans, to Tiger Sports Nation, as we bring you the ninth episode of this season. I'm Taylor Richardson.
And I'm Jack Woods. Before we get started, all of us here in the TSN studio would appreciate it if you could check us out on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. Just search DePauw Channel. Now, on to some football, where DePauw traveled to Denison this past weekend to play the top-ranked team in the conference.
The Tigers scored on their opening drive of the game, taking a 7-0 lead off a seven-yard run by Jared Stiver. The Big Red would answer on the ensuing drive, tying the game at 7 apiece going into the second quarter. However, the Tigers had no answer to the Denison's balanced offense and stifling defense, dropping the contest 42-7. They moved to 4-4 on the year and 4-3 in conference play, heading into next week's home game against Oberlin.
Women's soccer took home the regular season NCAC title on Saturday, defeating Kenyon 1-0 for their 10th clean sheet of the year. With the game all tied going up into the 90th minute of the game, senior Alex Berkeley scored the game's only goal from 24 yards out, hammering the ball into the bottom right-hand corner. The Tigers move to 11-5-2 and go into the conference tournament as the number one seed, playing Kenyon at home tonight.
While the women were at home, the men traveled to Kenyon to play their final game of the season. The Lords opened up the scoring in the fifth minute, taking a 1-0 lead all the way into halftime. In the second half, the Tigers saw very little of the ball and conceded three goals in the process, dropping the game 4-0. Despite the rough finish, the men finished the year 10-7-1 and 4-4-1 in conference play, and will look to build on what worked next fall. Here's Christian Bradford for another Eye of the Tiger segment featuring the men's and the women's soccer teams.
Welcome to Eye of the Tiger.
Hey guys, it's Christian again, back for another week of TSN's Eye of the Tiger. Right here, I have sophomore women's soccer player Allison Harvey. How are you doing today, Allison?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Fantastic. Before we start, I have to ask you, what is your favorite pump-up song?
Definitely Can't Touch This.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My music hits me so hard.
How do you feel being number one in the NCAC?
I think it's definitely a surprise to a lot of people, considering last year and how we did overall as a team, but I think it just shows that our team has faced a lot of adversities and we're here to do work this year and we're not messing around and we can face anybody and come out on top when we're playing our game.
Hey guys, I'm here with another sophomore, Maya Caldwell. So Maya, how do you adjust to the weather conditions?
At first we get pretty cold, but then we get used to it, and ultimately same conditions for both teams, so you just got to do what you can.
Hey guys!
What's up? My name's David.
I'm Chad.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Joe.
The name's Skip.
Mark with a C.
Brad.
I'm senior Shaylee Kumar.
And I'm Shaylee Alex Berkeley.
Okay, let's play. Thank you, Allison, for joining us today.
Thanks so much for having me.
Now let's take it to the men's team. Woo!
When I popped off, then you go game.
Oh, what's up, Jay? How you doing?
What's up, Christian? How you doing?
I'm good. So a couple days ago, I got the pleasure to meet with some of the members of the women's soccer team. And now I have the pleasure to meet with number 9, Jay Klein. How are you today?
I'm great. Thank you.
I have to ask, what's your favorite pop-up song?
The one you were just playing.
Wow. Small world. How was the season?
Unfortunately, it ended a couple days ago, but you always have to look for the bright side of things, and we played, I think, a pretty good season. We won 10 games out of our 18. I think, personally, I had a good senior year. Ended up with 11 goals and 3 assists, still on top of the conference in the standings, or the statistics, I mean, and hopefully that will hold for the next couple games while they play the playoff games.
What was it like being captain this year?
Being captain was something that I actually set as a goal for myself freshman year coming into the team. It was something I dreamed about because I had the opportunity to do that in high school soccer and knew that it's part of my personality, leadership, and I don't know, it was just really special to be captain of the team this year. Really appreciated the guys, you know, having my back on that and voting me in last season, because that's how we do it. It's a team vote. The coach doesn't decide. And just knowing that the guys supported me and thought that I was a good leader made it even better and made it a lot easier for me to, like, have the confidence to speak in the locker room and, you know, put myself in that light and be the voice of the team in front of everybody.
That's awesome. So, I've heard you had 8 PKs this season. Are you going to miss one now?
I'm going to take it real easy on you and kick it slow, and it's still going to go in.
Let's play.
All right, Christian, you say go whenever you're ready.
Okay. And go. Okay, another one. I was just warming up. Let's go. All right, cut.
Thank you for joining us today, Jay. Back to you at the sports desk.
Thank you, Christian. The women's swimming and diving team were in Elkhart on Saturday to swim against Bethel and Indiana Wesleyan, led by freshman Emily Thompson's two wins in the 200-yard butterfly and 400-yard individual medley. DePauw beat both teams handily, ousting Bethel 184-80 and Indiana Wesleyan 180.5-87.5. Congratulations. Also collecting two first-place finishes was Maddie Dixon in the 200-yard freestyle and 500-yard freestyle. The women will look to build on this momentum next weekend at the Wabash College Invitational. Good luck, ladies.
Good luck. The men's swimming and diving team won their home opener against the Little Giants of Wabash by a score of 169-128. Seth Fagan won both the 100-yard backstroke and the 200-yard backstroke, and teammate Charlie Stewart Bates also compiled two victories in the win, taking the first 200 free and the 500 free. They also beat Bethel 149-93 on Saturday, gaining confidence as they traveled to Chicago for a weekend-long tournament on Friday.
Men's cross country won their third consecutive conference championship on Saturday, compiling a total of 53 points, besting runner-up Wabash's 85 points. The Tigers had five runners in the top 15, three of which were named second-team all-conference. Senior Cole Martin was the only Tiger to be named first-team all-conference as he finished second in the race. Michael sat down with Cole to get his take on the race. Thank you, Cole, and congrats to the men. They'll be at Calvin College in 2 weeks for the regional meet on November 16th.
Yeah, good luck to them. The women also had a very successful conference meet, finishing fourth. Sophomore Jenny Knoll placed the team with her fifth place finish, earning her second consecutive first team all-conference honor. Albeit there were some rocky performances, other Tigers stepped up, including seniors Natalie Grushka and Maddie Barr, who each earned all-conference honors with 16th and 19th place finishes, respectively. The women will also be in Calvin in 2 weeks for a chance to qualify for the national meet.
The field hockey team won their final game of the season last Tuesday, defeating Earlham 3-2. After falling behind 2-0 in the second quarter, goals from Kate Milner and Alexis Style helped tie the game going into the fourth. 2 minutes into the final corner, Kate Milner scored the game winner and her second goal of the game, giving the Tigers the victory. DePauw goes into the conference tournament as the fourth-ranked team, playing Denison in Granville tonight.
Volleyball also had their last regular season match of the year, winning 1-2 at their tournament in St. Louis. After losing to Milliken in five sets, the Tigers came back and swept Center 3-0. Morgan Steerly and Liv Hartman had 9 of 8 kills, respectively, leading DePauw in that category heading into the conference tournament. The women are ranked fourth and looking to challenge for the trophy. They will play the winner of Hiram and Oberlin this weekend in Springfield, Ohio.
That just about wraps up our show. Thank you for tuning in and choosing D3 to stay up to date with everything DePauw Athletics. I'm Jack Woods.
And I'm Taylor Richardson. And as always,
roll TIGS.
Let's go.
Woo!
Libby Arrow, let's
Libby
go.
Arrow.